What's up, comic book fans and collectors of all ages? It's your girl, Miss Toy Diva, and I'd like to welcome you all to my channel, Fetch Toys. Just ladies and gentlemen, as promised, I'm going to have a comic book haul. It's going to be full of awesome covers, exclusive covers, variant covers, and man, oh man, it's a lot of comic books to show you, and I'm going to get right into it. The first one is issue number one. It is The Return of Jean Grey, Part 1, Phoenix Resurrection. Now, this one is in a lenticular cover. I don't know if the camera can catch it, but it's pretty awesome and dopeified, and I'm going to be following this series for sure. Really awesome and amazing covers. The second one, of course, is a variant cover from the Phoenix Resurrection, and that's pretty nice. I like that one. I tell you, some of these covers blow your mind. The next one is in another lenticular cover. It is issue number 675, part 1, The Avengers No Surrender. Wow, look at that. Look at that cover. If you, I'm hoping that this camera can catch that 3D style of lenticular covers. This is really awesome. Really, really nice. I really like those lenticular covers. The next one is issue number 676, part 2. And this is, of course, Avengers No Surrender. But check this out. I like how they have it. They have, you know, this person holding the first Avengers. Yeah, so I was really wanted this one. I'm like, this looks really, really cool. So I picked this one up as well. Pretty awesome and dopeified covers. Next one I have is Batman. Here we go from DC, number 35. This is celebrating 800 issues of Batman. I follow Batman, and I'm really, really enjoying it. 800 issues, that is sick. Another DC cover is issue number 1. Check this out. Batman 66 meets Wonder Woman. Are you kidding me? Look at that cover. Sick? What? Looking. Yes, that is awesome. You got Batman, Bruce Wayne. You know, look at Linda Carter. She is amazing looking. This artist really, really captured her a lot. I really like that one. Now, the next one I have is a great cover. I missed this one before, and I'm glad they did a second print. This is Batman Elmer Fudd, issue number 1. I remember when this came out, it flew off the shelves. Flew off the shelves. I never even had a chance to even pick this one up, but I'm glad that they reissued it and did it again, and I'm really, really happy about that. Next one I have is Flash. This is The Perfect Storm, part 1. This is issue number 9. Let's check that out. Gorilla Grodd is back. Yes, he's back with a vengeance. That is sick. I love this cover. I have Flash in my pull list, and I'm very, very happy. And the next is, of course, DC. I picked up a lot of DC covers. This is The Dark Days, The Forge, issue number 1. Check that out. So all the rest of them are going to be DCs. Really, really nice. Next DC is The Dark Days. Yes, this is the metallic version. Prelude of the Metal is the casting, issue number 1. Yes. The Metal coming in now. Here we go. This is the second cover. I think this is a variant cover of the casting right here. Batman and Wonder Woman. And here we have another Prelude to the Metal. This is before the Metal series came in. And this is another version of the two variant covers. Pretty awesome and amazing. Next we have, of course, DC, the big book, The Dark Knight Metal. Okay, this is issue number 1. This is the big book. Awesome, awesome series. Really enjoyed it. We have The Dark Knights issue number 2. Pretty sweet covers. These are nice. We have Dark Knight issue number, Metal issue number 3. I put this in my pull list. For some reason, I'm missing number 4, but this is The Dark Knight Metal issue number 5. I'm going to have to check my pull list to see where number 4 is at. But I also have a lot of tie-ins to The Dark Knight Metal. We have the number 1 is Batman the Drowned. That's pretty awesome. Look at these covers. Next we have Batman Dark Knight the Dawnbreaker. These are all tie-in covers. And I picked them pretty much all of them up. We have Dark Knight Batman The Murder Machine, another Metal tie-in. pretty awesome. So you guys can probably check your local comic book shops for these Dark Knight Hawkman found. Nice covers. Next we have another Dark Knight tie-in. This is Dark Knight Rising: The Wild Hunt. I mean, my comic book, he was just putting them in, and I was like, I'm just taking them. And we have all these number ones. We have Dark Knight, The Merciless, number one. Pretty awesome. A lot of tie-ins, and what? It doesn't stop there, because I'm going to, what? Keep giving and keep going. Next, from DC to Dark Knight's tie-in for the metal, we have Batman, The Red Death. That is nice. That's a nice cover. Next, we have Batman Lost. Again, another one. Dark Knight Metal tie-in. A lot of tie-ins to this awesome series. This is really, really nice, this one. This is Dark Knight, The Batman Who Laughs. Look at that. Look at that. Joker is up in there. Look at Robin. Looks so sinister. The Joker face. That is really nice. I think that was a big book right there. And the last tie-in for the Dark Knight Metal is Batman the Devastator. That was also a big book right there. So awesome and amazing covers. A lot of tie-ins to the Dark Knight Metal. Now I'm going to show you my DC Rebirth. This is another amazing series. And I believe this is an issue number 21. This is Batman and a Tickling cover. The Button series. Yes, you guys remember this one? This is a lenticular cover, so I hope you can see that. I'm hoping that this camera will pick it up, but that was awesome and amazing. If you guys can see maybe Flash in there, there he is right there. Awesome. You got Batman on one side, and you have the Flash on the other, so that was pretty, pretty cool. A lot of variants as well. Then we have another lenticular cover from, of course, a Flash, and here is issue number 21 of The Button. This is really nice. I hope you guys can pick these lenticular covers. I hope the camera picks it up. It's pretty awesome right there. Nice, nice covers. Then we have, of course, again, Batman. This is issue 22, another lenticular cover. I hope you can pick up the Flash if you can. There he is, right there. Pretty awesome. You got Batman. The Button series was amazing. Was really amazing. This is really, really nice. Let me look at the bottom. You guys can pick that up. I'm hoping that you can. Yeah, there it is. Right there. So this is pretty awesome. Sorry about the glare, but I just had the Button was really nice. Another lenticular cover from the number 22. And this is the old school. Look at the Flash. Look like an old school. That looks really, really nice. It's another lenticular cover. Looks like the old school. Hopefully you guys can pick it up. I'm hoping that you can. Look at that. Yeah, that is nice. That is really, really nice right there. Pretty wicked. I like that. These lenticular covers are really, really popular with fans and collectors, including myself. I see that the camera can pick it up. Look at that. Yes, really, really nice. So awesome and amazing. And of course, this is the regular version of it. It makes it look like an old school style. Look at that, $2.99, which is $2.99, the Button part 4. But look at that, that's the regular version of it right there. And then I have another version. This is another variant. Of course, the Flash one from issue 22. And that is pretty awesome. Next I really enjoyed this one. As soon as I saw it, I wanted it. This is Batman. This is issue 1 of 8. Batman White Knight. Everybody jumped on this one. Everybody jumped on that one, and including myself. So, yes. And this is issue number 2 of 8. Check that out. Bam. Sick. Look at both of these covers. Awesome and amazing. Nice, nice covers. I'm following that series. Pretty, pretty dope. And have more DC. Another big book. This is Doomsday Clock, issue number 1. And here it is right here. Bam. Yes. And this is a lenticular cover right here. Rorschach, as you can see. This book is huge. And hopefully you can see the logo inside, which is Superman. There it is. I hope you can see it's Superman Wonder Woman and Batman, the trio right there. So that came out around Rorschach, and then that is sick. I like how they did that lenticular cover. So that came out really, really nice, and it's dope right there. There it is, Superman, Wonder Woman, and you got the Batman logo. Nice. So that's a lenticular cover. Everybody's grabbing that one. My comic shop was lucky enough to get the midnight release, and here it is right here. That's the variant, right, the black and white variant. So I was really, really happy that he was able to get that one. Pretty dope. Next we have is issue number 2 of 12. This is the 12-part series. And here it is. This is issue number 2 right here. It's pretty awesome. Nice. I believe that might be Lex Luthor. Correct me if I'm wrong. And here we are, issue number 3 of 12. And here it is right here. So really, really love this series. And can't wait for more. This is a really, really great book. If you haven't picked up Doomsday Clock, definitely do so. Now I have 2 action figure variants from Star Wars. This is Star Wars issue number 36, which I love my action figure variants. This is Princess Leia in her Hoth outfit. That is nice. Now that is not, that's an action figure variant cover. That is sick looking. Captured Carrie Fisher. I mean, you can't get no better than that. Let's get a close-up so you guys can enjoy it. That is so awesome. Beautiful, beautiful. I really, really like that a lot. I miss her. And, of course, we have issue number 37. This is Rebel Commander right here. Look at that. Like I said, these action figure variant covers are pretty, pretty dopeified. Really like them all. And the next version of these are from the IDW. I noticed the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, but this is, I'm not sure about the covers on it, but they really looked nice. So this is issue number 72 right here, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Look at that. I forgot my comic shop. They told me what it was, the version of these different variant covers, but I just had to pick them up because they look dope. Next we have, again, from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. This is number 12, and this is Shredder. Of course, we know that this is Raphael right here, and Shredder. Look at that artwork. I really, really like it. Wait till you see these two. The next one is from the Transformers, the same style of artwork, and I really, really like it. This is issue number 8. Bam! Megatron. Isn't that dopeified? That is sick. I gotta ask my comic shop owner what is these covers called. And the next one, of course, is Optimus Prime issue number 9. They look so sick, so dope, and this Mos Def, awesome. And the last two ones that's really, really nice homage covers. This is the variant cover. They had a Mary Jane Watson variant covers. But this is really awesome. This is issue number 13. It's from a variant cover. Check this out. I know you guys probably know when you see it. Bam. Yes. Homage. This is a tribute to the first appearance of Punisher. That is sick. Let's get a close-up look on that one. You got the Punisher and Mary Jane Watson cover. So I can't wait to pick up more covers from that series of variants that came out. Really, really nice. They did a great, great job on this one. So awesome. Another awesome cover right here, which I really like, and it's a tribute of homage cover to we know the Incredible Hulk 181. This is issue number 25. Oh man, Logan, look at that. That is sick. That is sick right there. Two awesome, awesome covers, variant covers, homage covers. Really, really nice. Was glad to be able to pick that up. I think that was one in ten. 1 in 10 variant cover. But hey, it's a really popular book because it's from, you know, tribute to Incredible Hulk 181. So that's awesome. So guys and ladies, there you have it. There you go. Some of my awesome comic books that I picked up from my pull list. So thank you all for watching. Thank you all for stopping by. If you like this video, please hit that like button and feel free to subscribe to get my latest and newest videos. So smash that subscribe button, smash that notification button, share this video with your family and friends, and go to your comic shop or hobby shop and pick these awesome comic books up, because they are truly what? The bomb. Because more comic book haul videos, I'm going to do them more frequently in between my toy hauls. So guys, again, thank you all for supporting me and being there. Really appreciate your continuing support. This is your girl, Miss Toy Diva. Can you dig it? Can you dig them awesome comic books? I hope you can. Thanks for watching. Happy hunting. Have an awesome day. And I'll see you all, say what, on my next video.